You're bending both legs.
You
keep changing your
looks. So I'm here with EsNews Boxing. Brandon Cox is working with one of his young fighters. Why does he have one glove on?
Robert hurt his finger at school today, and people get injured, but that is no excuse to not train. And Robert, being the warrior that he is, he couldn't have waited to get in here and say, Coach, what can I do with only one hand? And there's limitless things we can do.
So what is he doing with one hand?
We're changing our levels and dropping a shot to the body. We're hitting a guy in the head, and then we're changing our levels to where his body is, and now we're hitting him in the body. This is an important thing. I don't want to hit my opponent in the head and stay at the same level and hit him in the body, because now I've left this opening, right? But if instead I were to attack the head and then get to the same level as the body shots, now I'm underneath that acute attack, okay? So that just buys me a millisecond in which to throw that shot, all right? And another important thing that I was having Robert remember to do is bend both, well, he's got one hand up, of course, but to bend both legs, because a lot of guys, they'll hit the head and then they'll reach in to hit the body and they'll only bend their front leg like this, and this causes them to lean forward out of position, right? But if you were to attack the head and set yourself and bend both legs, now I'm where I want to be with good power, and it's easy for me to come up and shoot. So that's what they're working on. In fact, put those gloves on, Daniel. I'll have it for you, right?
Okay. Let's see some work. Tim Bradley, he does a lot of that.
So
he gets
Rob,
low.
Let's show him first head, body, and then body, head. So head, body. Bend both legs. Bend your back leg. Body, head. Hey, much better. Head, body. Never bend your back leg. Body, head. Head, body. Looking good, looking good. Body, head. Head, body. Rest, rest, rest. You know, so maybe you're thinking like, Andy, come here. So maybe you're thinking like this. So you're attacking the head and you change your levels, you're attacking the body. Well, he'll just shoot down right there. Well, he sure as hell will if you just stay there, all right? So you have to understand that this occupies just the most brief moment in time. So I'm attacking Andy, and he's counterattacking me to the head, and we're exchanging at this level for a small period. I can be underneath that attack, right? And he keeps punching up. So now, if I stay down here, eventually he's going to make the transition to start punching down at me, but I should have already proactively made a decision to put myself in a new position, right? So as long as I'm proactive about what I want to do, changing levels is the correct way to attack the body. Let's show him one more time. Look.
Don't be afraid to take your time.
This is that classic jab to the chin, hook to the liver combo. This is a great way to drop that body shot. Step in hard with the jab. Now I need to change my levels, like we spoke about, bend my back leg like we spoke about. Now I'm at the good place to throw a hook to the body. Rollin' strong. Jab head, hook body. Very nice, very nice. Good, good, good. Keep your right hand up. Uh-huh, uh-huh. Very good. Good, good job. Doing good. Good punching. Bend your back leg also. Hey, you know what's another important thing about hitting the body is understanding that your guard changes relative to your opponent. So let's say I'm boxing you, Elisek, back and my hands are up. And you go, hey, your guard is pretty good. Your hands are protecting you, right? But if I were not to change anything and I were to drop down to hit you in the body, look, now you can see you can easily come over the top of my guard. While it was a good guard while it was up here, it's a poor guard while I'm down here. So what you need to remember to do is, as you change your levels, also change your guard relative to where your opponent's going to attack you, okay? So in each circumstance, my hands are up, but you can see, the viewers at home, that one, I'm not protected, and the other one, I still have defense, and better yet, I still have offense when I come back up. It may not seem like much, but I'd rather not have to move this extra 4 inches to strike the guy by just putting my hands in position to strike as I change my levels. Everything is about being economic, so these are some ways that you can remain economical in your techniques.
There you have it, Brandon Krause. Great explanation. Stay tuned at outlawsfeasonreport.com. I'm Elie Sekback reporting. You can follow me on Twitter, @Sekback.